First, thank you very much for organizing this very nice conference. So I will present some work on information cohomology and the issues for consciousness modeling and from elementary perception to machine learning. It's a work that has been done partially in collaboration with Daniel Benquin. And basically, I had planned to present to you some neuroscience results. There are many results on shapes and frozen information. And in machine learning also on unsupervised classification, but I will not have time, so I will focus basically on mathematics of and information cohomology framework. So basically what I will present is a neuroscience mathematical and physical approach of elementary qualitative consciousness called the qualia percept, which we try to unify in a cohomological theory of information and probability, and which accounts for the diversity of forms of consciousness. Consciousness corresponds in this case to a structural and hierarchical formed patterns of information, and you can consider it as a gestalt or a monadic theory a la Leibniz. It is a panpsychic theory for which unconscious is someone else's consciousness, so basically everything is conscious, like Pythagoras is supposed to have said, all things feel. And it is also a physicalist theory in the sense that elementary percept and knowledge is a fundamental form of energy. Subjective and objective, it and I from the bit, to refer to what presented Paul. I think therefore I am is completed by it moves, therefore it is, and it is the original definition of emotion, that goes with motion and anima. So in the world of thoughts, nothing is lost, nothing is created, everything is transformed, and this work conciliates and precise some models of consciousness such as neural assembly, integrated information, global neural workspace, free energy principle, and so on. So I will not focus on this. Maybe I'll start with an experience. So basically, we can try to prove to give an empirical proof of consciousness consistency. And any bistable or multistable stimuli like the Likert cube or whatever bistable can be seen as a non-contradiction principle as stated by Aristotle as the first. So basically, non-contradiction is yet the fundamental axiom of any mathematical consistent theory. So basically, you can hope to find some mathematics of consciousness because up to now, nobody can see both cubes at the same time, in the same respect, as said Aristotle. So this was, in fact, there is a long tradition of seeing mathematics as a cognition theory. For example, Cantor said that a set is a gathering together into a world of definite distant objects of a perception or of a thought, which are called the elements of the set, Cantor, and so on and so on. So here I will present some information. The framework is based on the information structure, which is based on the usual finite probability axiomatic given by Kolmogorov. So basically, it is seen geometrically as a simplex, a probability simplex. The geometry is affine due to this. It is convex. There are coordinates which are barycentric coordinates because of the theorem of total probability. And condition very important, conditioning is a projection into a lower dimensional subsimplex of the stuff. So this is the geometry of probability. The information functions we consider are the usual entropy, which is the Shannon entropy, the joint entropy, which is the usual joint entropy, the conditional entropy, which is also the usual conditional entropy, and the chain rule, which basically said that the entropy of k plus 1 variable minus the entropy of k variable is equal to entropy of the k plus 1 variable, knowing given condition by the other ones. So this is fundamental for the cohomology, we will see. Basically, if you don't know them, they are usually seen as a Venn diagram, looking at all the unions which can also be seen as the semi-lattice of the unions presented here. Here you have the entropy of the marginal, the entropy of the pairs of triplets, and so on, which can be also seen as a simplex function of the simplex, the same combinatorial aspect. The other functions we are interested in and which will be very important are the mutual information for perm, which is exactly the same but with the intersections, let's say. And the pair mutual information is defined by this as usual like this, but they are generalized to the multivariate k-dimensional case by alternated sum of the entropies. For example, the mutual information in between three variables is equal to the sum of the marginals minus the sum of the pairs plus the triplets. You have the conditional mutual information. You have also a chain rule. And we're also interested in integrated information, which was called, in fact, total correlation by Watanabe, which is the sum of the marginal minus the joint entropy. So we have a nice, very deep theorem of Euclid-Ewing, which states that information functions are in bijection with finite additive measurable functions with operators union, intersection, complement, and which corresponding to join mutual information and conditional information operation respectively. This makes the information functions a ring of functions. So basically, in Solovay's construction of Zemerlo-Frankel axiom with dependent choice, which is a weak axiom of choice, any set is and function are measurable. In fact, and in this context, information function becomes quite universal, and Solovay's measure axioms give some set of axioms for consciousness theory. What I point out is that you can see measure theory as stated first by Lebesgue in set theoretical terms, and then more generally can be seen as giving formal axioms for consciousness. And it can be generalized in the context of category theory, which is currently at work. So what are mutual informations? They measure dependencies. For example, we have the theorem that two variables are statistically independent if the mutual information vanish. And what they are measuring, they are generalizing correlation coefficient to nonlinear relations. So basically, this can be generalized to multivariate case, and several variables are mutually independent if and only if the 2 power n minus 1 mutual information equals 0. So it's a generalization. So to remind you about what is a simplex, a zero simplex is a point, a one simplex is an edge, a two simplex is a triangle, a three simplex is a tetrahedron, etc. So you can always see it as a combinatorial. This is the simplicial combinatorics. You can always associate it with a kind of set of subset lattice, which has the binomial combinatorics. So it's very easy. And you can see a simplicial complex as an algebraic sum, let's say very briefly, an algebraic sum of simplices or faces, which can also be represented within such a lattice. A cohomology is an homology first. Is a chain complex with a boundary which is defined by the boundary of a boundary is equal to zero. The boundary goes from one dimension, which is usually a differential operator that makes go from a dimension to a higher dimension, and the cohomology goes in the opposite sense. So it's a kind of in decomposition. So the setting of the cohomology for information consider random variables as partitions of the atomic probabilities of the atomic probabilities. It means that we're going to look at every equivalence classes. A partition and equivalence classes are the same, are equivalent. So we're going to look at all equivalent classes. So in terms of thought, it would be all that it is equivalent. And the partition gives the lattice of partition, which is a partial order, a poset. And here it is represented for a sample space of four elements, And you see that there is already plenty of stuff. And you have the operation of joining two variables, joint variable, which is given by the less fine partition that is finer than two, which is the greatest common divisor in the usual algebra. So the important stuff is that conditioning and conditioning information is a left action on the functional module, meaning that we're going to write it like this for the information of X conditioned by Y, which is to make it correspond exactly to the conditional entropy. And we define the complex of random variables. And here, the complex are made of random variables with the co-boundary, which is exactly the co-boundary of Hochschild and Galois co-boundary. So when we do this for the first step, we obtain for the co-cycle condition exactly the chain rule of information. And from this chain rule of information, we get the functional equation of entropy, which allows to derive uniquely entropy as the first cohomological class of the cohomology. So basically, we have unique characterization of entropy in this context. And what is nice also is that for even degrees, the boundary for even degree boundaries correspond to to odd degrees mutual information. So with odd number of variables, and in fact it is a doubly graded algebra. We have another co-boundary, which is with a trivial or symmetric action, depending it comes to the same. And in this case, and with this second co-boundary, we have the odd co-boundaries which give the even information. So what measure the information cohomology? It quantifies the statistical dependencies at all degrees and the obstruction to factorization. And the the independence corresponds with co-cycles. Okay. It can be formalized within a topos theory. Basically, because the image law of the random variables with the probability law it corresponds to a locality condition, which is very important for topos. The set of the topos is the category of information structure, which is given by what I presented you. It's very simple. The condition, the arrows are the conditioning. So basically, it can be important because associated to topos, there is a constructive logic, which is classically described in terms of Heiting algebras, which represents the Boolean, which is a generalization of Boolean, and which can be seen as corresponding to a multivalued logic. For instance, probability, you can imagine as a generalization of the Boolean binary logic to a continuum of truth. So I won't go in this. So what is nice is that everything can be computed, and in fact the lattice of partition is much too big from the combinatorial point of view to be computed effectively on actual computers. So we met the restriction and go back to the lattice of subset of the simplicial lattice, which correspond to the simplicial subscale of the homology, the simplicial homology of information. And this can be computed. Okay, the joint is the usual Boolean. The join and the meet is the usual join and meet of a Boolean algebra and define two opposite dual monoids. Okay, so it is very classical from the stuff. We define the internal energy as the self interaction as the first order, the marginal, the entropy of the marginal, and the mutual information at k quantifies the contribution of the k-body interaction, and we call the k-free free information. In fact, the total free energy is the total correlation or integrated information according to Tononi and Edelman, and quantify the total dependencies. So with this definition, we recover, if we put it in the phase space, we recover the usual thermodynamic stuff, and in any case, we have the entropy, which is equal to internal energy minus the free energy. Represent the information landscape as depending on the values of entropy or mutual information. For the mutual information, here we have all the marginal, the pair, the triplets, the quadruplets, and so on and so on. And an information path is a sequence of edge, and it's a piecewise linear function. the derivation of this piecewise linear function, the derivative, is minus the conditional mutual information. Okay, so we have represented all the information function on those scales. And we can get the usual inequalities that define cones and the non-Shannonian inequalities which is linked to negativity which define another cone. So basically, we have first nice theorem is that the set of all information paths is in bijection with the symmetric group, and we can see each path as a permutation, and it's also in bijection with a set of stochastic process. So we can see each path as a stochastic process, and we have a trivial analog of the second law, which state that the entropy that can only of a stochastic process can only increase with time, which is increasing the indices of the chain. This is basically a consequence of positivity of conditional information and convexity of logarithm, of minus logarithm. So, and it improves the result of cover that had to assume a Markov condition. We can also conjecture that there exists a discrete informational version of Noether theorem, which would correspond to the first law. So basically, we define positive information paths as a strictly decreasing path of mutual information, and this set of paths forms a simplicial complex, which we call the minimum free energy complex, which is represented here. This is what we can compute. There is a nice phenomena which is called, which is a negativity of mutual information for degrees higher than 2, so degrees 3. For example, if you take 3 random variables, binary random variables, they give a 7-dimensional simplex, and there are 2 minima of this in this simplex, which are exactly for pairwise, where the variables are pairwise independent, so they are unlinked, but they are linked 3 by 3 by a minus one information, mutual information. This is a purely high-dimensional effect. So we make it, we propose to make it as a link, topological links, like Borromean links. So basically, a little time, when we compute, we can use this information landscape and this compute this homology on data here on the genetic expression, and it allows to identify population of neurons to recognize here there was 10 neurons of a certain kind which happened to have a large mutual information at 10, and the information path identifies the 2 populations that were present in the stuff. So this is how it works, but unfortunately, when we compute the integrated information of Tononi-Edelman, so the total energy, instead of the mutual information, it cannot distinguish anymore the stuff. So it's what does it compute? It computes the correlations, the correlation in arbitrary dimension and generalized correlation for the maximum, for the positive information, and for the negative information it computes some, it finds some kind of clustering effects on the data, and this can we can in fact reformalize almost analogically all what is done with k-body interaction system in statistical physics, expressing some mean field stuff or a normalization-like framework. And this, we apply also this to images. So basically, I know that plenty of people here are interested by quantum. There is a generalization to quantum information topology cohomology, notably that we did with Daniel, but Vigneault did also stuff. But very importantly, Serre and Adami showed that the conditional information negativity can happen for k below 2, quantum in the quantum case for 2-body, and that it corresponds exactly to Bell inequalities and entanglement. So basically, and going to relation to space-time, following Schwinger, we can say that space-like, I can propose this is purely conjectural. Space-like relations are a kind of independence on negative information relations, and that the time-like relations are entropic positive-like relations. So this is how it could be done, but this is conjectural. So In conclusion, we had a monadic theory à la Leibniz of elementary quantitative and qualitative aspects of consciousness that accounts for diversity of forms of consciousness, the diversity being the different facets of the simplex, the different minima, let's say. And it consults integrated information theory, free energy principle, and, probably global space as we have some transitions. We can see Gestaltic theory, we find a Gestaltic theory equivalent to Galois cohomology that accounts for consciousness structure in terms of discrete and finite symmetries. And this is, I think, the quite very, quite new stuff, which is maybe important. And it makes coincide Galois ambiguity groups, permutation groups, the ambiguity of permutation with Shannon uncertainty. And it's directly quantifiable and computable with simply several restrictions in practice. This is a biophysical theory of consciousness. In fact, I didn't present, but information has a long history of quantification in neural systems and below neural systems, even at the molecular level. This generalized statistical physics to arbitrary data, it means that we don't need phase space or symplectic assumptions. So there is a logic which is in the spirit of Boole, let's say, the laws of thought on which are founded the mathematical theories of logic and probabilities. And we can try to think about space-time, how we can make it for space-time. So here are the reference of the work. And I thank all the collaborators and everybody. Any question?